Welcome back, everybody! Continuing on with In Sound Mind. Alright, so, it's possible that, you know, the red voice could be how Desmond views himself, sort of like
off.
There we go. Oh, did not like the sound of that. In the void. Into nothing. Daunting. Hungry for more. Flawed but fixable. What's with all the fish? Let's see, the monsters I was told that I was making up have now stepped forth out of the shadows. I don't like that sound. Ship is death. It bears death's name. I managed to find one of those flare guns from inside the belly of the beast. I'm not afraid to use it. Well, neither am I, and I need it!
It's an old oil. Worth a try.
See, every bit of me is dark. Crash.
Then cast magic missile at it!
What the? That was kinda odd. Desmond, he would understand. Well, he's doing his best to do that right now. Okay, so I have been in here. Of course. Thank you. one more oil can left.
I don't want to move forward. The lantern is off.
Yeah, these lanterns... Oh, you've got to be kidding me! Catch me if you can!
The door leading to the courtyard is locked.
Let's see, Agent something or other. Let's call him Mulder. Agent Mulder's instructions are to take highly flammable containers of something from the bay where the something, I guess something is, and move them indoors. No smoking, flare guns, or explosives near this crap. Keep an eye on that driver smoking around transport. If he gives you crap about it, arrest him. Hello?
In a world full of darkness, it is reasonable to try and find light. Alan did. When he went down to that ship. But did it clear the way, or did it set his world aflame? I dare you to go down there and find out.
Find a fire source to clear the blockage in the lighthouse, okay? Let's see, welcome to Icarus Point, a guided tour of the oldest lighthouse in the Pacific Northwest. We start our tour at the Lighthouse Museum, a faithful recreation of the original lighthouse keeper lodging. Our tour continues in the courtyard, which offers a breathtaking view of Patmos Bay. If you're feeling bold, take the route beneath the courtyard to visit the old boathouse. Finally, we end our tour at the top of the lighthouse, where the red light of damnation will devour your eternal soul. That took a dark turn! We hope you enjoy your time at Icarus Point, and if a certain therapist is reading this, we look forward to seeing you die. Okay! So, ignoring his father's instructions not to fly too close to the sun, and it in turn melting the wax of his wings, Icarus fell out of the sky and into the ocean where he found his death at the hands of his hubris. To go down there and poke around and poke at his dead body? Not particularly.
It's a fuse box. It's no use.
Fuses into that. Good thing I know where the other two are. Dang it. Yeah, that's what I thought.
I'm growing darker.
Okay.
Brother!
Yeah, I think that red voice dude, it could be sort
it's
of
a fuse box.
There you go. What did that do? I'm not sure that we actually did anything.
Too much for one man.
Never mind. Hey, so, you know, the dude in the yellow trench coat. Oh, great. All those years of playing Mario are paying off! Woohoo! Uh-oh. Ow! Jerk! It'd be taking a while to load. Okay, so maybe that icon was really just schmuck bait all along. I don't know. Okay, so I kind of have to wonder if the red voice is kind of like the monsters from the monsters in these. Ow! It's kind of like the monsters in a lot of these cassette. Crap! If it's the like the monsters in a lot of these cassette tapes, or if it's more of a representation of. You know, kind of like the guy who's sort of Desmond's boss or kind of watching over him or whatever from Meyer Pharmaceuticals. And kind of keeping tabs on him and his reports and all that. And basically, Desmond just started catching on to what's going on. because of that. That red voice dude. Yeah, that's why he wants Desmond to die. It's because Desmond has started catching on and he knows too much. I guess I gotta go. There! Ow! Stop pummeling me! What the heck? Yeah. Okay, this way.
It's blocked from the other side.
Gotta be kidding me.
It's blocked from the other side.
There ain't no other way to go! Hey, I think it's... No idea what that achievement was for. Kind of reminds you of Aunt Josephine's house from a series of unfortunate events. Crap. Ow. Aha! I was right! Uh-oh. That's the instructions. Boat mechanism. Lowering a small boat into the water is a two-man job. Do not attempt to lower the boat on your own. Once a person is safely in the boat, a second person will use the crank to slowly lower the boat down to the water. Always check the boat and rope for breaks and tears before use. I'm supposed to get in and cut the rope using this, aren't I?
Ooh, glad to see it's still good.
Missed!
I'll come back for this if I need it. I should sit in the boat first. It's a base for a crank wheel. No luck.
you stop that? I get it, you don't like the boathouse. Why does it keep going that way? Oh.
Too much for one man.
Yeah, batteries.
Later, maybe.
What is that anyway? Corn?
It's a base for a crank wheel. Out if I turn it too tight.
Oh wait. How the crap am I supposed to get in there now? Because I need that crank wheel. Okay, that's why there's a crawl space there. Well, this sucks! Alright, you have to push it from this side, but then again... Because you need the crank to turn the mechanism for the boat. But if it, you end up pulling it out, the gate just slams shut.
Can't carry any more of this. It's a base for a crank wheel. It pops out if I turn it too tight.
And it slams down too fast to just run underneath. Thank you. thinking here. I wonder. Let's see. Yeah, because if there's a way to run it through the wall there, you could actually get out with the crank. But it doesn't look like the game lets you do that. Have to fiddle with this. Yeah, there's the buzzer just now, folks. So, as always, do not stop being awesome, and I'll catch you in the next video. Until then, take care.